Hello everyone! Today I thought I should make kind of a masterboard with these crafty board tags and show you a fun and easy way to get started and create backgrounds that you can continue to play on later and in a quick way make into what you need. If it's a birthday gift or something else you want to create. So I start to tape down just the frame to keep that one in place. And just see that all the shapes are in its place. And then I want to use the multi-surface paint. These are really great, and on a light background like this cat hair, you don't need to bother go over it with gesso, because these the coverage of these are great. So let's start putting on paint, and it's nothing fancy. I just want paint on there. Now I want to add some black, and I do that by using stamps, and I'm just using random stamps for some interest. This is from the crunchy mushroom stamp set, and make art keys stamp set, just to get some text and something going on, and black. This will probably not be readable at the end. Because I want to do some stenciling over it later. Now I will use these and put the teal stenciling parts over the warmer colors and the pink over the colder colors to get contrast. Now I want to bring in some white. And I make a few. And now I try to hear the text is really visible and I want to break it up. So I just make part of this white. And then I will use the white Posca pen and make circles like so. And then I think I want some white splatters. Okay, so now our masterboard craftyboard is done. Remember, this is just the backgrounds, but it's a really quick and fun way to do multiple backgrounds. And instead of making a masterboard, die cutting, maybe double up with different layers for sturdiness, I think these crafty board alternatives is really great for tags. And remember to always keep these. This could be a quite nice embellishment on something you want to embellish on your some of your mixed media projects. So here they are. I want to just do some finishing touches. Let's see where I have my... my spongy thingy. Here it is. Blending tool is the name. Spongy thingy is my name. And just go around the edges. I use VersaFine ink, and you get your edges nice and dark, and you kind of frame your tag, and I think it makes them look finished. Okay, the very last step I want to do now is to bring in some more black to the surface layer, and I just want to use a pigment ink, waterproof fine line pencil. Make sure your paint is really dry. I have ruined so many pencils over the year. And this doesn't have to be neat. If you want it neat, of course you can just put the stencil back and just make the line like so. But I don't mind if it's a little bit wonky. that was a little video on how to make some mixed media backgrounds quick, easy, using the That's Crafty Grayboard tag sheet. I wish you a great day, and I see you next time, and then I think I will turn some of these into finished tags. See you soon again. Bye bye.